the Philippine House of Representatives turns over the proposed 2024 national budget to the Senate. The lower chamber approved the 5.7 trillion peso spending bill on the third and final reading on September before Congress went on recess. The amended measure includes over 194 billion pesos in realigned funds that aim to boost national defense, fight global inflation, and ensure food security. House Speaker Martin Romualdez says the 2024 budget was meticulously reviewed to address pressing concerns of Filipinos. The Senate, for its part, aims to approve the spending bill before the 27th of November. Bring down the price of rice and go after agricultural hoarders and smugglers. The Philippine Agriculture Department says these are the priorities of its new secretary, fishing tycoon Francisco Q. Laurel Jr. Marcos, who used to head the Philippine Agri Portfolio, has vowed to use the full force of law against smugglers and hoarders, whom he believes disrupt supplies in the Philippines.
Ang ating bagong kalihim ay hindi bago sa agriculture, hindi lang sa pangisdaan. Matagal na namin siyang nakakasama sa mga meetings sa Palacio through the Private Sector Advisory Council dahil member siya doon.
Motorists are expected or are in for another oil price rollback this week. Estimates show a liter of diesel could be cheaper by up to 1 peso and 20 centavos, while a liter of gasoline could go down by up to 60 centavos. As for kerosene, prices are expected to dip by at least 80 centavos. Timor-Leste President Jose Ramos Horta will be in the Philippines on November 10 for a state visit. Malacañang says the visit aims to boost the bilateral relations between the Philippines and Timor-Leste. It adds the visit will tackle various areas of cooperation between the two countries in terms of technical, political, educational, and economic partnerships. Now, suspended Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board Chairman Teofilo Guades III now back in his post. Guades had been slapped with a 90-day suspension order over corruption allegations. But in a statement, Transportation Chief Jaime Bautista cited the recantation of the allegations by former LTFRB officer Jeff Tumbado as basis for lifting the suspension order. Guades welcomes the move and pledges to uphold the standards and of integrity and transparency in leading the agency. Filipinos starting to return to the metro following the extended holiday due to the Village and Youth Council polls and the Undas break. Over at the Parañaque Integrated Terminal Exchange, officials there had anticipated at least 150,000 passengers arriving on Sunday. They also assured travelers that there are enough buses to accommodate everyone. Meanwhile, some bus drivers traveling the South Luzon Expressway have reported traffic buildup due to several road works. And officials at the North Luzon Expressway warning travelers that they can expect that there will still be a lot of passengers using the highway on Monday. In Calamba Town in Misamis Occidental, where a radio broadcaster was shot dead early Sunday while on air. Police say Juan Humalon was doing a live broadcast at his home early Sunday when an unidentified gunman shot him in the head. The assailant was able to flee the scene, but local police say they have leads on the suspect based on the testimony of the victim's child. Let's get an update now on the weather from Pagasa forecaster Benison Estereja. Hi, Benison.
Hello, Katrina, and all our viewers. As of now, we're not seeing any weather disturbance, whether low pressure area or tropical cyclone in and out of the Philippine area of responsibility. We have the easterlies affecting Palawan, Visayas, and Mindanao, which means Palawan will have cloudy skies with some scattered rain showers and thunderstorms due to easterlies, whereas the rest of southern Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao will have partly cloudy to cloudy skies with some isolated rain showers due to easterlies and localized thunderstorms. On the other hand, we have the northeast monsoon starting to pick up over here in extreme northern Luzon. So Batanes and Babuyan Islands will have slightly cooler weather for this morning and some isolated light rains. And in the coming days, 2 to 3 days in particular, we will have some partly cloudy to cloudy skies with some isolated light rains over Cagayan Valley, most of central Luzon, Cordillera region, and Ilocos region. And for Metro Manila, expect some partly cloudy to cloudy skies still in the next 3 days and some localized thunderstorms mostly in the afternoon or evening. And that's the latest from Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Benison Estereja reporting.
Thank you for joining us this morning, Pag-asa forecaster Benison Estereja. President Marcos orders Philippine police to conduct a thorough probe into the death of Juan Humalon. The chief executive says attacks on journalists will not be tolerated and warns those who threaten the freedom of the press will face consequences. A special investigation task group has been formed to look into the killing as condemnation continues to pour in. Media Watchdog, the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines, urges the government to strengthen the enforcement of laws protecting the media.
Pinapatunayan na may breakdown ng due process at saka ng batas or law, rule of law. Pero ang gusto sana natin ay may gawin talagang konkretong mga aksyon. Kaya lang, yung tatlong taon na kay Juan Humalon, wala pang resolution yung mga kaso nila.
The Philippine Justice Department, for its part, reaffirms its commitment to safeguarding journalists in the wake of Humalon's death. It vows to create a safe environment where journalists can work safely without fear of violence. Humalon is the second journalist killed this year and the fourth under the Marcos administration.